For quite a while now, I've been wanting to build a trailer to pull behind a quad. I scrounged up these hubs right here, and that set of springs off an old trailer that was getting thrown away. These are 4-on-4. And then these are the old tires off the front of my quad, and I bought a set of 4-on-4 12-inch wheels to mount these tires on. They ought to last forever on a little trailer. But I made this axle up probably a year ago, this piece of galvanized pipe. I made that up about a year ago, and right now the ground froze. Can't do anything outside much. It's colder than hell. So I thought, you know, this is a good time to build that little trailer. So I'm gonna fool with this thing. It's not a priority. If it warms up and I can work outside, I will. But as long as I got the time, I'm gonna fool with this thing. Anyway, so kind of keep up with this thing and see how it goes. Working on this little trailer. I got the axle done and I got this basic frame built right here. Trying to figure out how I want to do the tongue. I want to be able to jackknife this trailer, so if you're in a really bad spot, you can back the quad, this tire right here, right up against the tongue without hitting the trailer. You know. So anyway, I got this much done. I'll get this tongue figured out, and then I'll figure out what I want to do. I think the sides are going to come up right off of that frame and then run out over the tire and then up maybe about 6 inches on both sides. Just put a little more room in the trailer, and I think it'll look better too. Also, it'll act like a fender, so this thing ain't throwing mud all over me. Anyway, this is kind of how it's going to set. Pretty close to where the trailer would actually set behind the quad. This is what I wanted here. If you get in a really tight spot and you got to turn this whole thing around without unhooking the trailer, you want to be able to get this quad almost perpendicular to that trailer. So 30 inch tongue, that'll work right there. And I think the height is about right. I haven't even tried to figure out the height yet between the trailer and the quad. I'll do that right now before I get much further, but this is looking pretty good. Yeah, I like the way this is turning out here. All right, I got the upper part. This is the part that goes out over the tire right there. It comes down here, goes across, comes up, goes out. I got that all jigged. None of it's welded. I'm just getting ready to do that. The only thing is bugging me now, if I put this in, I can't get the floor in and out in one piece unless I shorten it. In other words, I'm closing the hole down by an inch and a half, which there's no other way to do it. But, so I think I'll just shorten that floor a little bit so I can get it in and out. But anyway, I'm gonna tack this thing all together, then probably bolt everything up on the axles and finish the rest from there. That's what I'm kind of thinking. Anyway, it's January or February 6th, I think. It's about 30 degrees. Beautiful day. Little trailer coming along. I got it all jigged up and about half welded together. That is going to be all of the framework. I got some little braces and stuff have to go in. But that pretty much covers it. Back of the trailer there, that's where a little door will go. Little D-wall come out over the tires. Anyway, I welded this thing together. I got it about half welded, like I said. One of them crappy kind of 31, 32 degree days. Wants to rain, looks like, but anyway, things are going pretty good. That little trailer fits right in behind this quad perfectly. Don't hang out nowhere. So the quad will go through between a couple trees and the trailer will follow. Got this thing welded up. It needs now the floors put in, the outer skin put on, and then the door built for the back of it there. Now this tongue is longer than it's going to be. I just haven't cut it yet. I just kind of set this thing up here to see how it is, and it's actually looking pretty good, man. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with this thing. The only thing here I might have screwed up, I only gave that about 2 inches of clearance there. Probably should have went another inch. Don't know. Easy to fix all. I can just put a shim between the frame and the spring shackles hanger right there. The Black Daily just put an inch shim in there. Easy fix. But I wish I'd have gone another inch right there. Anyway, back of this thing is looking pretty good. That gets a door right there. Probably going to build that door so I can take it off. Or build it so I can swing it down and actually use it to like roll a generator up in there or a compressor or whatever. But I think this little thing's going to work out pretty good. Still got a couple pieces of iron to put in right here. Piece goes across right here to catch that upper little floor. Yeah, if we get a spike camp back in Big Canyon, this thing can haul all that junk in there in one trip and out in one trip without having to, you know, make multiple trips. It's like 18 miles. So this is going to be a good deal. But like I said, I wish I'd have gave that just a little more room. Darn it. Here, hindsight 2020, isn't it? I think I had it figured right. I just measured from the wrong spot. I think what I did, I needed 8 inches, but I think it was off the top of that rail right there. And I think I went off the bottom. That just about do it right there. So I think that's what I did. Yeah, you gotta make mistakes once in a while. Anyway, easy fix, no big deal. One of them cruddy 39 degree day today. Trying to rain, but it's just having a hard time. But it's just one of them kind of crappy, depressing days. Yeah, I got this frame pretty much done. I got it all primed, getting ready to put the sides and stuff on it. I still need to get the hitch for up there. Got to order that. Everything else is pretty much done. There's the wheels and axle and that stuff. And I painted all this with a brush. It seems to cover better when you do it with a brush rather than a spray gun. But when I actually put the finish on it, I'll spray it. And while that thing is drying and stuff, I just made up all of the side panels. This big T-looking thing here is the front panel. There's the two rear panels. And then there's the four side pieces. The floor to it is right over there in the corner, that green looking thing. That's just a piece of wood thing I made up, piece of junk, but it'll work. So as soon as this dries, tomorrow sometime, because it's cold and it's not going to dry fast, what I'll do is I'll rivet all of this metal onto that frame. And when that's all done, and then this is already pre-primed, so I don't have to prime that. Then I'll paint this with a finish, shoot it with a spray gun, and the trailer will be done. And in my spare time, I've been working on this little door. This is the, damn, almost fell down. This is the rear door that goes on the trailer. Dang thing is just a little bit too big. I gotta shorten it by a quarter of an inch. It needs to be 16 and it's 16 and a quarter. That's pretty normal stuff though. So I get this little door all set up, get it welded, and then it'll get a piece of sheet iron on it also, and then it'll hinge. It'll just probably hinge down. I might hinge it sideways, but probably just hinge it down. So this thing is getting pretty close. They're working on this little trailer. I put the floor in it yesterday. and I'm really wanting to get this thing done, and I painted it today, and it's about 2 o'clock and it's only 32 degrees, so probably shouldn't have painted it, but I want to get this darn thing done. Then when I get it, I want to mount the wheels and axle and stuff on here and then roll it over. That's why I painted this. Get in a hurry here. Then all I have left to do is to put that that pan in, and the same thing on this side. Other than that, this thing is pretty much done except for the rear door. All the panels are on. It's all taken care of. So as soon as this paint dries, probably a week, then I'll put the axle and springs and tires and wheels back on this thing, turn it over, put those panels in, the door I got laying here, yeah. Anyway, and get this thing done. But it's only gonna be about 32 today, so it takes about 3 days for this paint to set up when it's this cold. But it does set up, so that's where I'm at. Yeah, this little trailer coming right along. I got it almost done, not quite. Working on this back door. Just got the hinges made, they're laying right there. I'm gonna swing it sideways. I was thinking, you know, you pull an elk up in there, if you can't get him all in and the rump's hanging out or something, if the door swung down, then you'd end up pretty much dragging it. So I'm gonna swing it sideways. That way you could just pull it over and tie it with a rope. Well, I got this little trailer. It's looking pretty good. It's about what I wanted. I still got these two, that panel and that panel right there to put on. I broke my cutter, so I gotta go to town and replace it. Anyway, yeah, this thing is turning out pretty trick, actually. I still need the connector right there. No big deal. But this is gonna work pretty good. Tug Dog, what are you doing, buddy? Chelsea Dog. Yeah, I got a couple inches of snow last night. Sun is just trying to peek over the hill there. Comes up right there. Here's where it came up last winter. It goes right through the little gap. Now it comes up right here and crosses over. And I get about 5 hours of sun. So this snow is going to go away pretty fast. As soon as that sun gets down here, it's 40 degrees already. So this is going to go away pretty fast. Keeps right on a trucking. Well, there it is, all done. I think it took about 2 weeks to build this thing, I guess. Anyway, it's all done. I think it turned out pretty trick. It's been so cold, I painted this whole thing with a brush, and it's got like 3 coats on it, but the paint is really, really soft. I might have screwed up because it was so cold. Anyway, got all this thing done. There's the door. Door swings sideways. The little thing tracked really good. Anyway, just kind of playing with it today. Anyway, now it's on to something else. It's warming up, middle of March. Probably start cutting brush. Yeah, this little door swings sideways. Anyway, now I can haul my stuff around. Got a couple inches of snow last night. Anyway, done deal.